So, Morbius the Living Vampire hits theaters July 31st of this year, 2020. My only question is, which one of Jared Leto's characters had the more frightening teeth? Morbius or Joker?
What? Joker. What? The Joker jokes aren't played out, are they? It was fucking terrible.
Let's watch.
Now get the guns, the drugs, from my generation, I'll take the fall. The saints, and across the nation, and it's a sin. The guns, the fake, the fraud, the messer with me. Come on, come on, come on, let's get it out.
Morbius trailer is rated and should be arriving soon. This article from ScreenRant.com yesterday. This is Sandy Schaefer. Sony and Jared Leto's Morbius the Living Vampire's movie trailer receives a rating and is expected to arrive with Bad Boys for Life in theaters. Let's just all hope that this is far better than his portrayal of Joker, which I think it will be. Sony's Morbius movie trailer has been rated and is expected to arrive very soon. Although the studio currently shares Peter Parker with the MCU, Sony has started to develop a Spider-Man universe of its own lately. Based around the web-slingers, anti-heroes, and enemies, the franchise kicked off with the box office success of Venom back in October 2018 and also has solo films led by Nightwatch, Kraven the Hunter, Black Cat, and Silver Sable in different stages of development. Up next, however, is Michael Morbius, who's better known by his superpowered alias Morbius the Living Vampire. Jared Leto stars as Morbius' namesake, a scientist whose attempt to cure himself of a rare blood disease goes wrong when he afflicts himself with a form of vampirism instead. This is, of course, the second recent major comic book tentpole for Oscar winner, following his polarizing turn as the Joker in David Ayer's Suicide Squad, a role which he isn't expected to reprise in the near future, if ever again. That's just a no. He's not ever going to reprise that role again. Let's be perfectly clear with that. Sony has yet to release any official images or footage of Leto in the character for the movie, but that should change within the next week or so. According to Trailer Track, the first Morbius trailer, which reportedly runs at just over 2.5 minutes long, has been rated by the Alberta Film Ratings and should be arriving within a matter of days. The trailer will almost undoubtedly premiere in theaters with Sony's Bad Boys for Life when the sequel opens next week and should drop online sometime before then. Even more than Venom, it's presumed Morbius will be a darker superhero movie with more than a touch of body horror. Case in point, the film was written by Lost in Space showrunners Matt Sazema and Burke Sharpless, whose previous credits include 2014's very superhero-esque take on Count Dracula, Dracula Untold. Equally, Morbius was directed by Daniel Espinosa, a filmmaker who tends to specialize in the macabre genre fare like the dramatic thriller Child 44 and the sci-fi horror offering Life, a film any half-joke could have easily been the secret prequel to Venom. Interestingly, Morbius is one of two Marvel comic book movies opening in 2020 that combine superhero and horror tropes, along with April's The New Mutants, which I am excited for after 3.5 years of waiting. Commercially speaking, Morbius is far less of a surefire bet than Venom was. The character himself is most unknown outside of the dedicated comic book reading community, and Leto is similarly less bankable than Tom Hardy when it comes to selling the masses on a Spider-Man spin-off project. That's all the more reason then for Sony to get the movie's marketing up and going this month, well ahead of Morbius' scheduled release date in July. That would be July 31st of this year, 2020. Assuming the footage is well received, it should start to generate more hype for what's currently one of this year's more intriguing superhero films, but also one of the more questionable and possibly unreliable ones. This is the point where I want to know what you think now. You've heard my thoughts. We got this Morbius movie played by this Jared Leto character who the last time we saw him was playing the Joker. So I'm really interested to know you guys' thoughts on this because I really am kind of indifferent. He's such a niche character that I'm really not sure if I'm going to go see this in the theater, if it's worth my time or my money. I've never read the comics. Like I said, I'm just not too familiar with this character. I know as Jared Leto is a talented actor. His portrayal of Joker was just god-awful and something that should be buried and forgotten and never talked about again. But unfortunately, with him playing a superhero movie, or in another superhero-type movie, we have to have that discussion. And like they said, this is a very niche market character, very highly unknown outside of hardcore comic fans. So this is a risk to involve him in this universe already this early out, I think, with only having Venom under your belt in your whole Spider-Verse or Venom-verse, as you want to call it, over on this side of things. So I don't know, guys. I'm really anxious to kind of see how this all pans out. I really want to see the trailer, which should be coming out in a couple days. I'm fingers crossed we get it tomorrow or Saturday. I doubt it'll be tomorrow, so it'll probably be Monday or Monday morning. But I don't know. So here's where you can follow us on social media. You can follow us at, oh yeah, The Place to Be Reviews on Instagram, The Place to Be Reviews fan page on Facebook. That's the official group. That is the group, the private group of The Place to Be Reviews. There's also The Place to Be Reviews page. You can follow us on Twitter at The Place to Be RE1. Also, you can follow me at N80Pete on Twitter. You can email us theplacetobereviews@mail.com. The world's best mail. That's it. Be sure to check back because there's an intro. It's late. Messed up words. There's another video coming up next. And you can tell this is a raw cut because I didn't feel like editing that out. I'm just going with it at this point. So follow us on social media. Thank you. Remember, what do I always say? Hey, if I don't see you, have a great day and a pleasant tomorrow. I'm out. That's it. We're done.